Commitment 2010 coverage now with the second part of our series in the race for Nebraska governor. Tonight, we're asking incumbent Dave Heineman and challenger Mike Meister about one of the hottest topics in the state, how to keep the economy strong during the ongoing recession. Here's KATV NewsWatch 7's Todd Andrews.
Ask a lot of Omahaans what they think the keys to Nebraska's economic survival are, and they'll say economic development.
More businesses, I guess, you know, or more opportunities.
We put the same line of questions to both Governor Dave Heineman and his challenger, Mike Meister. First, asking them about the state's greatest strengths.
We have 12 sectors in our economy, from agriculture to insurance to biotechnology to telecommunications, where we can continue to grow.
I think our biggest strength lies in the actual mix that we have between urban and rural economies.
Of course, the state's survival begins and ends with the budget, how much revenue the government can take in and how much it can cut back on spending. In that area, both incumbent and challenger have different approaches. Among Meister's ideas, exploring new ventures.
For instance, develop our game and parks to be a much more user-friendly option, maybe institute some public-private partnerships.
Among Heineman's, holding the line on spending and taxes.
And we're going to continue to invest in our property tax credit, so that we can help at the state level provide some property tax relief.
Meister adds that he would look to privatize where possible.
Training programs are always something that comes up.
Heineman adds that Nebraska's low unemployment rate and foreclosure rate are good signs amid the recession and indications that the state's economy is poised for recovery.
We've got a strong foundation. The key is to better educate our people so that we can increase the higher-paying jobs into our state.
With Commitment 2010 coverage, Todd Andrews, KETV News Watch 7.
We'll continue our all-encompassing conversations with the gubernatorial candidates next Monday when our topic shifts to Nebraska's struggle with the so-called brain drain.